Dear students, I am Archana HR, working as assistant professor in department of ECE. So in continuation with the previous labs which we have done in our regular sessions for the mixed signal design, herewith we are giving you a small insight about the op-amp design and the extraction of the ADL. So here we have the differential amplifier. As we all are aware of op-amp design, it comprises of a differential amplifier circuit as well as a common source amplifier. So this is a differential amplifier circuit which most of you would have done in your regular lab. So please be sure that you are taking the proper devices with W by L ratios as specified here. So the differential amplifier, once it is run, finally you will be getting a gain of nearly around 100. Now with the help of the differential amplifier as well as the common source circuit, we have a simple op-amp being designed here. It comprises of two blocks. As you can see, it's a differential amplifier and the common source amplifier. So with the differential amplifier, we have the input of IDC V1 and V2, and VDD is taken here from both VCC and VDD of our differential amplifier and a common source amplifier. The gain which we obtained from a common source amplifier in our regular lab, it was around 4.5 to 5. So when we are doing a cascade of differential amplifier and a common source amplifier, the total gain which we are going to generate from the general op-amp, it is going to give around 4K. So writing the test bench for an operational amplifier, we have a general op-amp like this, and we have a current source IDC which 30 microamperes. The input at the AC signal component here, it is going to be with the specifications mentioned, frequency of around 1K, the amplitude maintained at 5 micro. So the VDC plus 2.5 and minus 2.5 are taken here correspondingly for VDD and VSS. The output is checked here at a V out point. So now what we are going to do is we are just going to write the test bench obtained like this, and then we are going to launch the ADL window. So in the ADL window, we have the specifications which are to be given here. The analysis, we have AC-DC, AC analysis. So the analysis we are going to choose. So here we have the transient analysis, setup time, stop time here, which is given as 5 milli. Select the moderate, enable, then apply. Then the AC analysis, the DC analysis, we have the component parameter, the component name, select the component, we have the AC source, the DC voltage, then go back to the ADEL window, then in the DC again, we have the start and stop minus 2.5 to plus 2.5. Apply. Then the AC component, start and stop time 10 to 1 gigahertz. Select the sweep type as logarithmic, then apply points per decade 20. So with all these specifications, we are supposed to plot the output. To be plotted, select on the design, the input side and the output side. Go back to the ADEL environment and run. So you can see the three responses which appear here. So once we just check into the different types of analysis, what we can find here is the transient response, the DC response, and the AC response. The value of this gain in the AC response signifies the value of your gain in the op amp. So the same thing we can just find out with the values which are generated in the transient response and find out the gain of the total op amp design.